Jonathan from Rain Brothers here with a quick video on how to troubleshoot a jet pump. This is an above ground pump that is drawing water from a water cistern out in the yard. And on the jet pump, this is the suction line. Ideally, we need to have a priming port at the highest level on the pump, and then that suction line should run downhill the entire way to the water tank. And then inside the water tank, there needs to be a check valve, which there is in this case, a check valve or a foot valve, that because this, once this pump generates pressure, it's gonna send that water pressure back through this suction line, and it's gonna hit that check valve and hold water pressure all through here, and more importantly, hold that water so the pump stays primed. So this is set up correctly. We have the priming port at the very top. This is where we would pour in water upon initial installation. But we got called out to this customer's house. They were having problems with the jet pump. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna shut off the valve. So this is the supply side of the pump. It's going into this pressure tank with a shutoff valve here immediately downstream of the pressure tank. We're gonna close this valve off, which then isolates everything downstream of the valve inside the house. And then we're gonna watch this pressure gauge to see if it drops. If this pressure gauge drops with this main valve closed, we know there's a leak somewhere. Hopefully that leak is under the pressure tank, on one of these fittings, or around the pump. If it's not, and that pressure is dropping, that leak is somewhere in the suction line. Typically, if you have a leak in the suction line, it's going to be in the check valve itself. It could also be in the suction and the intake piping inside the cistern. So if we're diagnosing, we always look at the check valve first, make sure that all the plumbing connections are tight around the check valve, and then we'll check where that intake plumbing is tied into the cistern wall. In this case, these are precast concrete tanks. They have 1¼ inch female threaded coupling in the wall. So we're gonna check that connection to make sure there's no drips there. Those are the most likely places for a leak to occur. And in this case, sure enough, the check valve had actually separated from the intake pipe, which caused this pump to continually run as water was being ejected back out that suction line into the tank. So it was just blowing all this excess water pressure back into the cistern. So we got that repaired. We got this closed. Once we did that repair on the check valve, what we did was, with the power off, we removed this priming cap, poured fresh, clean water into this priming port, and that flooded this suction line all the way back to the cistern. You want to have, probably it's a good idea to have about 5 gallons of fresh water available. Depending on how long that suction line is, sometimes you have to reprime to get this pump going again. So we poured the water in. You want to make sure this valve is off so that water's not flowing in multiple directions or losing prime. Ideally, you want to have a shutoff valve between this pump and the pressure tank so that water, so you're not having to prime this pressure tank to pour excess water in here. So we have a shutoff valve here, we can just pour water in. But in this case, we poured water in and we wait until that water level rises all the way to the top. Watch it for a second, make sure all the air is released, that water level doesn't drop again. If you see that water level drop, pour more water in and keep monitoring it. And if it continues to drop, it means there's still a leak in that suction line somewhere. Once you get this primed, put the cap back on. Then in this particular case, we turn the power back on. We're gonna keep this closed, but keep a hand on this valve, and we're gonna use it to throttle open this water line. And in this particular case, you can see we have a low level, low pressure shutoff, cutoff pressure switch on here. What this does is protects the pump if the water pressure ever, if the pump does lose prime, the water pressure drops below 12 psi, this will automatically kick the pump off to save the pump. But in order to restart the pump, we actually have to hold this up just slightly at about a 45 degree angle. We have to keep hold of it and then run that pump and watch this pressure gauge and watch it build pressure. What you'll notice is as you're getting a pump going again, especially with these jet pumps, you have to hold this, let it build just a little bit of pressure, and you'll see that pressure gauge bob up and down. It'll keep moving like this. Keep a hold of that, keep that pump going, and then throttle this valve open just slightly, and it helps also to have a sink or something open in the house to purge air. But you're just gonna slightly crack that valve and let water start flowing through. If you open this valve and that pressure gauge immediately drops to zero, close the valve again, wait for it to build a little bit, and then crack it open just slightly. Listen for that motor. You'll be able to hear a difference in the pump when it starts to draw in water. You're gonna keep throttling this open just slightly, slightly, slightly until it keeps building pressure in the line, and you'll see that pressure gauge slowly start to build. Once that pressure gauge slowly starts to build, once it gets past about 20 PSI, you can let go of this and let the pump keep running and watch that pressure gauge. If it continues to move up, you can slowly open it, and then open it all the way once it's taken over and is not bobbing anymore on the pressure gauge. At that point, you keep a faucet open, purge all that air out. Once the air's out, close the faucet, and you should be good to go. You may have to do this a few times, may have to run it a few times to reprime it, but it will work as long as you follow those steps. Thanks for watching.